Power BI community, get ready to dive into this month's Power BI update. I'm Patrick LeBlanc, Principal Program Manager on the Azure Data team at Microsoft. Before we dive into this month's update, I want to share with you that we'll be bringing FabCon to Europe in September. There will be 10 full day tutorials, a partner pre-day, more than 120 sessions from the product team and the community, and you don't want to miss our swag feel power hour. If you've never been to a power hour before, be sure to add that to your schedule. FabCon will be landing in Vienna, Austria on September 15th through the 18th. Now, check out aka.ms/FCE for all the details and register with the code FABCOMM, that is FABCOMM, to save 200 euros. Now, let's check out the updates for August and find out how these new features and capabilities can supercharge your data analysis. This month's update includes some GA features, a list of new preview features, a community highlight, and of course, some call to actions. So sit back, grab some coffee, and let's jump into this month's update. Let's jump into these generally available features. First up, Copilot to write measure descriptions. Okay, so Copilot can instantly generate clear, helpful measure descriptions with just one click. This means report creators and authors can get context when they need it, where they need it. And so even when they can't see the DAX expression, so I go out and write some complicated DAX, they use it in their report, they have no idea what this means, but now the creators can get context that they need, even when they can't see those DAX expressions, making the reports easier to understand and use. Try this update out and see how it can enhance collaboration and accuracy in your Power BI projects. That's it for our GA features, but we have a long list of preview features to check out, starting with an update to creating direct lake models in Power BI Desktop. This month, Power BI Desktop now allows you to connect to mirrored Azure Databricks catalogs and add direct lake tables directly into your semantic model, whether you're editing a model or starting from scratch and creating a new one. Simply select the desired Azure Databricks catalog from the OneLake catalog, pick your tables, and add them with ease. This update expands your data integration options across lakehouses, warehouses, Fabric SQL databases, and other mirror databases in Microsoft Fabric, making advanced analytics more accessible than ever. But you don't believe me? Guess what? Zoe has a demo that walks you through all of this. Zoe, take it away.
In this release, we're excited to announce you can now add tables in direct lake mode from mirrored Azure Databricks catalogs. Simply go to the OneLake catalog and pick your mirrored item, and then you can create that direct lake semantic model. Here, I'm just going to pick one table from my item. And now in desktop, we're using direct lake on OneLake, which allows you to now go in and add other direct lake tables from other Fabric items. So here I'm going to pick a SQL database, which is also backed by OneLake, and I can bring in the tables I need for this semantic model from all the tables that are available in this Fabric item. I also can go in a third time, right? And so I can bring in a third table, my date table for my lakehouse again. This direct lake in desktop allows you to bring in tables from anywhere in the OneLake and combine them all together in the semantic model. So once I have them here, I can go to DAX Query View. I can run queries to see the data, and I can also do other semantic modeling here too, right? So I notice my table name here is maybe not as friendly. I can quickly go and rename this table, and I can also create measures. So if I want to get a simple count of this table, I can use a quick queries to define a new measure, which will simply count the rows in this table. I can use the DAX editor here to go ahead and give that a nice name. And when I'm ready, I can save it back to the model, right? So I can run it, make sure it's returning, and then update the model when ready. Another feature we have over in Model View is on any measure, we can create a description with Copilot. And we're excited to announce in this release, we are making this generally available.
What an amazing demo, Zoe. Let's jump to the next feature. The next preview feature is filtered report summaries and answers in the standalone Copilot experience. If you haven't checked out this new standalone Copilot experience, I suggest you go and kick the tires on it. It's pretty nice. But this new update, this new feature in Power BI makes it easier than ever to get precise insights. Now, Copilot can intelligently apply relevant filters to your questions, even if you haven't set those filters in the original report. So you can ask specific questions like, what were my sales in 2024? And receive a very accurate and contextual answer. This update enables deeper, more interactive conversations with your data, letting you explore and understand key metrics without needing to open, get this, the actual report or manually manage filters. Now, we have a demo from Carly for a more in-depth look. Let's check it out now.
Here, I have a Power BI report with two filters applied, season equals all and island name equals Oahu. Previously, responses in the standalone Copilot experience could only reflect what was currently visible on the report page behind those filters, without the ability to apply any additional existing filters. With this update, report responses in the standalone experience will intelligently apply relevant filters from that report and render them in line to better answer user questions. You give a clear indication with the filter icon too of what's been applied so that I can understand how to read and how to interpret the summary. Here, I'm going to dynamically apply two more filters. What about Maui and Spring? And see that both Maui and Spring were dynamically changed so I can have a clear conversation with my data. I can also click on one of the visual references and see that in the report itself, the filters are applied.
Thanks, Carly, for the great demo. The next preview feature, support for org apps in Pro Workspaces. That's right. You don't need a Fabric SKU. You don't need a premium capacity. You can now create and distribute multiple organizational apps per workspace, tailoring each app to different groups like leadership or managers or cross-team projects. Enjoy more flexibility and control in how you share reports with experiences customized for each and every audience. This is exciting. So now, if you don't have premium, if you don't have a Fabric SKU, if you just have Pro, you can experience these new org apps. Next up, we have an update to edit your data model in the Power BI service. The latest preview features includes improved error handling in Power Query. Now, if a query fails, you can relaunch and retry changes without starting over. Plus, there's now support for native queries when connecting to a data source in Power Query, giving you even more flexibility and control. Go try it out. Next up is semantic model refresh templates with Fabric Data Pipelines. Semantic model refresh templates in Power BI makes it easy to automate semantic model refreshes using Fabric Data Pipelines. Simply choose and customize templates for scenarios like event-driven, data flow, scheduled, or multi-model refreshes. No need for complex topics. Let's check out a demo from Grace for a look at this feature in action.
Semantic model refresh templates in Power BI enable users to orchestrate semantic model refreshes using Fabric Data Pipelines, providing a low-code, streamlined way to visualize and sequence refresh activities for common scenarios. You can access these templates by selecting Create Advanced Refresh from the Refresh dropdown on the Semantic Model Details page in your Microsoft Fabric workspace. This opens a template gallery, which includes several common refresh scenarios, such as event-driven refreshes, refreshing a semantic model after data flow runs, scheduled refreshes, and sequencing multiple semantic model refreshes. We'll click the Refresh Semantic Model after data flow runs. After selecting a template, you will be guided through the configuration process. The activities defined by the template will appear on the pipeline canvas, and you can configure each activity individually. For example, you will be prompted to select the data flow and workspace that should trigger the refresh, typically the data flow your semantic model depends on. Next, for the semantic model refresh settings, you will be guided to select the connection, workspace, and semantic model you want refreshed. For more granular control, you can choose specific tables or partitions for incremental refresh scenarios where you might only want to update the changed table's data rather than the entire model. You can enhance this pipeline with additional activities. For example, you can set up a Teams notification that alerts stakeholders after a refresh succeeds or fails. You can also set up a scheduled refresh to define when and how often these refreshes occur, with flexible options such as minute by minute, hourly, monthly, or quarterly intervals. If you want to add another template later, you can reopen the template gallery from the pipeline ribbon in the Home tab. Once you've finished configuring your pipeline, save and run. The output section will display the status of each activity as it runs.
Thanks for the great demo, Grace. To wrap up this long list of preview features is the Impala Connector implementation 2.0 is in preview. The new Impala Connector, now available in preview, leverages the open source Aero Database Connectivity, or ADBC. It's a driver for a modernized and more efficient connection experience. This update introduces a streamlined SQL generator format, bringing enhanced performance, security, and easier maintenance to your Impala integration. If you're using Impala, this is definitely something you want to check out. Now that we've wrapped up the highlights for this month's update, let's get to know Arwa. Each month, we highlight a community member that's making a positive impact in our community. Meet Arwa. She has been a Power BI community member since July 2024. Arwa has received more than 80 kudos, authored over 25 solutions, has over 90 replies, is a blog author, user group leader, and a super user in the community. Wow, she's busy. Driven by a passion for clarity and inclusion, this data storyteller thrives on transforming complex information into simple, relatable narratives. With a deep commitment to accessibility, she champions technology and learning for all, especially in regions with limited resources. As the proud founder of the Sudan's first community dedicated to Microsoft Fabric and Power BI, Arwa is breaking new grounds and building bridges. As a Microsoft super user, she finds joy in helping others grow their skills and confidence. For Arwa, data isn't just numbers, like Patrick. It's an art waiting to be revealed. Thank you for being a part of our community, Arwa. Okay, we have some call to actions. Now that you've seen what's new and what's coming in Power BI, it's time to take the next step. We want you to get hands-on with these updates and help shape the future of Power BI. Here's how you can get involved. Number one, try out the new features. We encourage you to try out the new features and share your feedback with us. Your input helps us improve and deliver the best experience possible. Number two, refer to the documentation. For more details on the new features and how to use them, please refer to the documentation provided in the respective sections. And number three, stay tuned for updates. Stay tuned for the updates in the upcoming months as new capabilities are shared. We encourage you to visit our Power BI community forums at aka.ms/PBI community, where you can connect with peers and find answers to all your questions. Also, your feedback truly matters to us. We're always listening. If there are any specific demos or topics you'd like us to cover in the future, or if you just have any questions, post them in the comments below. If this is your first time here, be sure to hit that subscribe button. If you like this video, big thumbs up. And as always, for Microsoft and myself, thanks for watching. We'll see you next month.